Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. In the name of Allah, the Most Beneficent, the Most Merciful. Atrophy is defined as shrinkage in the size of cell by loss of cell substance. When a sufficient number of cells involved, the entire tissue or organ diminishes in size. Mechanism is protein synthesis is decreased, protein catabolism is increased, decreased mitochondria and myofilaments, and decrease in endoplasmic reticulum. So, decrease in the cellular size lead to the decrease in the organ. For example, this is the normal epithelium and then there is atrophic epithelium. It can be divided into physiologic atrophy and pathologic. Physiologic can occur in embryonic life or in adult life, and pathologic may be local or generalized. There are number of multiple causes of atrophy. Testicular atrophy is a medical condition in which the male reproductive organs, the testes, which in humans are located in the scrotum, diminish in size and may be accompanied by loss of function. You can see the normal anatomy of the testes. They are suspended in the scrotum by spermatic cord, and this is the body of the testes. Now the normally their temperature affect the slightly lower than the average body temperature in the scrotum, and this is the length, width and height of normal testes. Surah Tariq in the Quran says, then let man see from what he is created. He is created from a fluid gushing forth, emerging from between the backbone and the rim, and this is the descent of the testes. Now, histologically, they are composed of lobules, and lobules contain seminiferous tubules. Seminiferous tubules are separated by interstitial connective tissue and Leydig cells. Leydig cells, they produce testosterone. You can appreciate under the microscope, there is HNE stained tissue. You can appreciate seminiferous tubules lined by sterilized cells. They produce spermatocytes. In between is connective tissue and blood vessels, and there are Leydig cells in the interstitium which produce testosterone. This is the normal histology, but when there is atrophy, you can appreciate the tubules are lined apart. There is increased in the Leydig cell, which is termed Leydig cell hyperplasia, and there is increase in the fibrous tissue, which is called fibrosis. So atrophic testes will show seminiferous tubules with loss of spermatogenesis. So you can compare the atrophic testes with the normal histology. Now, causes of testicular atrophy may be congenital or acquired. Two common causes are testicular dysgenesis or cryptorchidism and genetic abnormalities, and usually acquired are testicular trauma, torsion, post-inflammatory mumps, exogenous factors, testicular cancer and systemic diseases. So usually congenital are presented in the early age. So patient with genetic abnormality, Klinefelter's syndrome will present lack of body and head hair, gynecomastia and infertility, and on biopsy there will be atrophy of the seminiferous tubule. So analyze the data, clinical scenario, photomicrograph, write the points of identification: atrophic seminiferous tubules, Leydig cell hyperplasia, interstitial fibrosis. Name of the lesion is atrophy testes. And this is the gross morphology. Atrophic testes is smaller in size and decreased in volume than normal testes. Sometimes the size only 2 cm in greatest dimension. So diagnosis will be analyzing the data along with clinical scenario, photograph. The points of identification will be size of the testes is small according to the age of the patient. So name of the lesion is atrophic testes. Now if the patient is cryptorchidism, the parents may feel absence of testes in the scrotum in a child, or may be presented in an adult with history of infertility. Cryptorchidism is a failure of testicular descent into the scrotum, and 1% of 1-year-old male infants may present with the descent, incomplete descent. It may be bilateral or even unilateral. There is increased 3 to 5-fold increased risk of testicular cancer. Early archaeopexy reduces the risk for sterility and cancer. So the biopsy will show typical features: seminiferous tubules are atrophic, Leydig hyperplasia and fibrosis. So diagnosis will be analyze the data, clinical scenario photograph, write the points of identification: atrophic seminiferous tubules, Leydig hyperplasia and interstitial fibrosis. Thank you. Please like and share the video.